Hey guys, welcome back to a new video. So today I'm doing a vlog just of what I'm doing today. Waking in the white sunlight, yeah. Waiting through the days in nights out. It's a slow cinnamon summer. Your spells pulling me under. You'll have to excuse the clothes. I've just got trackies, whirlies, and a short sleeve t-shirt because I'm still a little bit sick, if you know, like I've had a really nasty cold for the last week and a half or so, and I just want to wear comfy clothes. So I've got a wormer here because we need to go out and worm Avanti, who's on spell. So she's just like 10 minutes down the road, so we're gonna go and worm her. I've got Darden up show jumping on these two on the right on Saturday. So Lisha and that's Nelly, a client horse. So Nelly is in the 45 and 65, or 45 and 60. And then Lisha is in the 80 and 90. So that's very exciting. I think that we're gonna camp there on Friday night, just because it starts really early being in the 45s and we don't wanna have to get up at like before 5 to get there, cause it's an hour and 15 minute drive. But yeah, so we're gonna go and worm Vu, and then I'm gonna ride Lisha. I'm gonna flat her. So this is the wormer that we're using. It's Strategy T. So what we do with the wormers is we don't just like alternate brands randomly. We actually look at what the main ingredient is, like the active ingredient. And for this one, it is pyrantel embernate and then oxfendazole. So next time that we worm the horses, we will use a wormer that does not have either of those in it. We'll use one that has different ingredients because that basically targets different types of worms so that they don't build resistance. And we will only worm them every couple months. Like, we don't do them every like 6 weeks or anything, because then they just become ineffective, especially if you use the same active ingredients. This one targets small strong guiles, large strong guiles, pinworms, large roundworms, and also aids in the control of tapeworms. This is a broad spectrum wormer, so it does most worms. We do swap them around. We don't just randomly change brands. We just do it based off of what the active ingredients are. But yeah, all my horses just got done with Strategy T recently, and we're just worming Avanti now because that's when the owner of the spell property has wormed all of her horses. So they're getting done all at the same time. So next time with the horses, we'll use something else, but yeah.
So I've got the wormer all here set up, and this is her halter just sitting on the gate. And now we have to find her in all of this. I need to find my horse. Hey! I found you! Hi, baby! Hi! Hello! You're nowhere near as hairy. You've lost all the disgusting winter coat. Hi, pretty girl! Hi! Hello. Hi.
Ugh.
It's looking pretty good. Give me. Yeah, her neck is so thick now. She's still not too keen on eating. Yucky taste. Okay. The halter is back and we are leaving.
My eyes are so puffy because I've just had my allergies flare up heaps. I've got my Flybuster mask, which is what I got for Fish. It's a fly bow. And then I got a halter and a lead rope, all from Main Event Equestrian. So I'm just going to go and fit all this stuff to her now.
So here is the fly bow. It's got ear holes and also a forelock hole, which is very important for Fish because she has got a massive forelock. And I also got this one because you can still see their face in it, and I like being able to see their face. So here is my halter, lead rope, and fly veil, all from Main Event Equestrian. So I've taken off the fly veil, seeing as though she doesn't actually need it on right now. I'm just going to tuck her up and ride her. I'm really not feeling very well, but we will push on. So that one's going to be a show halter, so I've just put it back into the bag and put this one on her. So I'm going to get her a little bit of feed, which will just be some chaff here, just like a little bit less than a scoop of chaff, and then a little bit of this, which is Pegasus Sweet Rice. It's like muesli. She can just have a little bit of that as a little pre-ride snack, so she's coming in her stomach. Get that, put that there. Get my feed stirrer, a little bit of water from here. Yep, that'll do. And give it a stir. Hi. There you go, madam. So while she eats that, I'm gonna go run up to the house and get some tissues.
When my allergies get too bad, I wear a mask. You can see like how red that eye is because it's so irritated. So I'm actually gonna wear a mask to keep the allergies out. I've got my tissues and a drink bottle as well.
Hi, darling. Hi. Hi. Lisha's got these very strange little rubbed out parts on both sides where the saddle goes. You can see here as well. And not entirely sure what it's from because her saddles were fitted a couple weeks ago and it just appeared after Serpentine Hickstead. So I think it's from our saddle blanket that we used. So I'm not going to use that saddle blanket anymore. I'm going to have to find a different one to use for cross country. But yeah, it's not bothering her at all. It's just rubbed off hair. So maybe the saddle pad was just putting a bit of extra pressure or rubbing it there or something like that. But bit unfortunate.
But I'll be there next time. I'll be there next time. I can't complain. No, I won't be mourning. I skipped on prom for Elvis Duran in the morning. Yeah. All of my life I have been starving. Now for a dinner with friends, more of a starving artist.
What happened here? Why does your saddle look all funky? It looks fine on the other side.
It's another Friday, and all my friends say,
I'm putting some tissues in my pocket so I'm well prepared, and I'm taking down the Pivo. So as many of you will know, I swap between riding with nothing, riding with a whip, riding with spurs, and riding with spurs and a whip. And so today I'm just riding with the whip. Yeah, I just thought that some of you might be interested.
Maybe that's why I haven't seen friends in a while. They're at a bar down in the Bahamas. While I'm doing promo, trying to blow up in Chicago. Yep, yep, I'm gonna miss this someday. Yep, yep, I'll miss another Friday. And all my friends say,
under that mask. Well, unfortunately my Pivo doesn't have much power, so it literally only got like 3 minutes of stuff, but oh well. Fish was very, very difficult at the start. She was quite like just fighting me on all my aids, but by the end she was really quite good. But I didn't really get any of the good stuff, unfortunately. But, oh well. And I have a dentist appointment now, so I'll go to that. Hi, Cheeky. What are you doing?
But I'll be more clicks this year, or should I follow the click in my ear? Should I go for more clicks this year? Or should I follow the click in my ear? Should I go for more clicks this year? Or should I follow the click in my ear? Should I go for more clicks this year?
It's not molasses water, darling. It's black because you're dirty.
And that's the water that's left is all black and gross. I'm just going to tip this out over the grass.
Thank you.
Taking Fishy back to the paddock.
Okay, so Fish is back in the paddock. I've started sneezing again. I'm just gonna put this back into the tack shed, and I'm also gonna grab the Pivo so I can charge it.
The Pivo is on charge.
I'm just sitting in the car. We are back home from the dentist appointment. All is good. I am literally so drained. Allergies are just not doing me any good today. So I'm gonna ride Nelly tomorrow because we're heading up to Dunnup show jumping tomorrow. So I'll ride her at the grounds then, and Lisha will have tomorrow off, and then they'll both get ridden the next day at the show. This was probably really boring, but I hope you enjoyed this anyways. Let me know what else you would like to see. Thanks for watching. Bye!